So in previous video in Comets module there was a very small bug. When we deleted the comment, the comments were getting the empty array in recipe, but still in the database there were IDs related to the recipes, but the comments were actually deleted. So the IDs contained in the comments were invalid. So I have fixed that bug, and now we are going to test that functionality. It is a very small bug. So let's first clear the database. Let's clear the recipes. Let's drop the table. Let's delete all the comments just to avoid any confusion. Yeah, now we are good to go. Let's first create a recipe. Okay, recipe is created. Let's get its details. Okay, right now there are no comments. Now let's add a comment on that recipe. So comment was added. Now this is the comments that we are getting on that recipe. Now let's try deleting this comment as well as the comment object in the list of this recipe. So it's the comment should be gone by from here and also from the database. So let's test it. So okay, this is the comment ID and this is the recipe ID. Yeah, the comment deleted. Let's fetch the details. Okay, the comment was deleted. Now let's see whether it actually deleted from the database. So here is our database. Let's refresh, and here we have our recipes which does not have comments. That's a good thing. Previously we had seen a ID even though the comment was deleted, so we don't have that comment, neither it exists in this list. So first what happens is that the comment will be spliced, or a comment will be deleted from the recipe first. If the recipe exists, the comment will be first deleted, then the comment from the actual its record will be deleted. Let's verify it whether it was deleted. Yes, it was deleted. So there is a small mistake here. This condition should be inside the if condition, because if the user is not authenticated or if the comment does not happens to be given by the logged in user, then we should throw error, you're not allowed to delete this comment. So it's good now. So that's all for this video, and with this small fix we have completed the server side part of our project. The next videos, upcoming videos, will be regarding the Android app, so they will be shortly been uploaded when I will have the necessary resources like fonts, images, icons, and a very simple UI design ready. So I will just create a basic wireframe and go on adding some attractive UI as the app progresses. So that's it for this video.